This is a demonstration of another tool called OffCrack. And OffCrack works differently, a little bit differently than John the Ripper, in that it uses something called rainbow tables. And a rainbow table is a pre-computed lookup table offering a time-memory trade-off that is used in recovering plain text passwords from a password hash generated by hash functions, such as a cryptographic hash function. So obviously rainbow tables work differently than the types of attacks used in John the Ripper. A rainbow table is essentially a collection of hashes is a collection of pre-computed hashes along with the actual password. So it includes the pre-computed hash and the password. And so what we see with a rainbow table is we have a list of hashes, and then alongside of that is the actual password listed, including any salt. And so a rainbow table may contain hundreds of thousands or even millions of these hash password combinations. And so what happens in a rainbow table is that the hash is compared with the contents of the rainbow table. So the first hash would be compared to this. If it matched, then we know that the password is albatross. If it matched the second hash that we see here, and these are MD5s by the way, then we know that the password is aardvark. And so you compare each hash to all of the thousands or millions of different pre-computed hashes in order to identify the password. So obviously this is going to be very computationally intensive. It's also going to work very quickly, because all you're doing is comparing the hash that you've already obtained from the source, either the SAM file, the security access module in Windows, or the shadow file in Linux, and then comparing it to something in essentially a text file. So it goes fairly quickly, but obviously to do the most complete job, you're going to need a very large rainbow table. And those do exist. And so OffCrack is free software that allows you to do a password audit on Windows or in Linux. And you can run this either from your Windows box directly, or you can load it up onto an ISO or a thumb drive and boot off that in order to do your password auditing. And we see here on OffCrack's site they have Windows and they have Linux sources. Obviously this says this is a source file, so you need to compile this for whatever Linux you need. So you could run this on Linux. Here's also the live CD for both XP and Vista. They changed the security in between XP and Vista, and it's much harder to crack the Vista passwords than it is the XP, so thank goodness that currently XP is the most often used Windows system, although I'm sure that will be supplanted by Windows 7 here soon. They also have a list of tables that you can see here. Some of these are free. The very small ones are free. And remember, we're doing this for security auditing purposes. We're not doing these just to crack somebody's password. So the free ones are, while quite large, are still small compared to the ones that you can download commercially. And this shows you the various types of tables that they include. Notice that the ones here, that the German and the XP Special, are going to be commercial versions. And you can see that the size of these in a compressed format is 7.4 gigabytes for both the German and the XP Special version. However, they have free versions, the XP Free Small and XP Free Fast, which are freely downloadable, although they obviously aren't as extensive as the two above, because you notice the size here, 380 megabytes. And 703 megabytes. And so there's really only need to download one of these free ones. The small can run in RAM, and if you have sufficient RAM, actually the free can run in RAM, but you can see that's probably about double the number of hashes in the free fast as compared with the free small. And this shows you down here the lengths of the passwords. Is that this does a brute force attack initially, but it only does it from 1 to 4 characters. And so obviously, because it's such a small character, everything else after that is done by comparing the rainbow table elements to the actual hashes. So notice it actually goes up to 14 characters. Why is 14 characters chosen? Well, you should know that already from our Windows password auditing discussion lecture. And so I'm not going to go any further into that here. And so here's where you can download the rainbow tables. Notice that the character sets are only alphanumeric. So as soon as if anybody includes any kind of special character in their password, the rainbow tables aren't going to work. But you can see that there's 26 plus 26 is 52 plus the 10 number characters. So there's a possible 62 different combinations in here, as well as in this character set here. If you'd like to pay the money, and I don't know how much this is, but you can get the XP Special or the XP Special German versions, which now also include the special character set. And of course, you can always create your own, but that's a huge undertaking, so it's probably worth the money if you're doing this for commercial purposes to go ahead and pay for these rainbow tables. So now let's see how Offcrack works. So you can download Offcrack for free. And here we see this is the icon for it. And let's start this up. And here's our user interface. And so you want to load either a single hash or this is called a pwdump, the hashes that have been extracted from a Windows SAM file using a application pwdump, which has been around for a while. And all that does is it extracts hashes from the SAM file, and it's on version 6 right now. It can also do an encrypted SAM, a local SAM, or a remote SAM. And in our simple demonstration here, we're just going to do a local SAM file. And I've created several different accounts with different types of passwords of different complexity, so we'll see how this works. And it's going to go very fast. And here I've actually got two different rainbow tables loaded, and I don't need both of them. I actually only need the fast, because the fast also so includes the small. Note here is where you can install your rainbow tables. Let me see if I can delete this one right here. Notice it has the special versions, German versions, and it's also got the Vista versions. Remember, if you're doing this on Vista or Windows 7, it's going to take a very long time to break any passwords. You have the added layer of security. So I've disabled XP Small here, so we're only going to be running the XP Free Fast. When you install these, you're going to have to install them in a particular place, and Offcrack will automatically create a tables subdirectory, so you can install your rainbow tables in this directory underneath the Offcrack directory. Once you install that, you can first, if you're doing this locally, what we're doing here is that, and that occurred way too quickly, unfortunately. Essentially what happened is pwdump 6 is a DOS program, and it ran out and identified the SAM file in its usual location, and then it extracted the password. So we see the password here has the username, the LANMAN hash, the NT hash, and recall that the LANMAN password is can be up to 14 characters, and then it's divided into two 7 character passwords. And then it is put into upper character. So only upper characters are used for the LANMAN password. The NT password can be up to 14 characters, and it is there's no changes to that. And the next thing you'll want to do is to increase the efficiency of the cracking is that you don't want to include any accounts that you don't want to break. And so help assistant and guest, let me see if there's anything else on here. Yeah, we'll include these. And take out support. So I'm not sure how many passwords I have in here. Let's move this down a little bit. So I have quite a few passwords in here. I'm going to take out administrator too. And so I have maybe 20 different passwords in here. 20 different accounts with different passwords. Notice that some of these don't have a LANMAN hash, but they do have an NT hash. And we've already got our tables loaded. Also note you can go to the statistics tab here and display the graphs after you run this to see how much time it took to crack the complexity category and the length of the password, to see an overall view of what your passwords look like that you had cracked, how many you didn't crack. You can also set your preferences here, the number of threads, depending upon how many cores you have. So you can increase the number of threads, which obviously make this run a lot faster. Number of hashes per task, maximum length of the disk queue. Brute force, yeah, we'll include brute force in here because I think I have some passwords in here that are only 4 characters. Hide usernames, no, and audit mode. I'm not sure what that means, but we'll put no on here. And now we need to restart because we changed the number of threads here. So we'll close this and we'll open it back up. Now we need to load that SAM file again, the local SAM, and hopefully it'll be a little slower. And it works very quickly. That's good. That's because I ran this several times yesterday just to see how well it worked. Let's go back in and take out these accounts that I don't want to break. And there, okay. And so now we're going to click crack down here. I'm not sure why it's saying it passwords found 2 of 22. I don't see that it found any yet. So preloading, waiting, brute force. Notice this will go quickly. Again, it's only 4 characters that it's going to brute force with from the set of 62 different characters in the alphabet. It shows the time elapsed. So let's go to crack and see what happens. Okay, let's stop it right there. You noticed immediately, notice that brute force is 13% done. It's already brute forced 2 different passwords for E. Smith 1213 and for A. J. Hib AAA. So the brute force with only 4 characters went very quickly. Notice that on the landman password, this is looking at the second set of 7 different characters, which means that D, S, Edo, I, E, S, and D were guessed as the end of the second set of characters, of the total second characters in the landman password. And so obviously this is only single character, 3 characters, so this went very quickly with respect to brute forcing. However, what we don't have, though, is the first 7 characters here for C. Hendrickson, nor for F. Montana, for K. Horsemeister, and so on. So with the 7 characters, with a possible 62 character alphabet, may or may not break with respect to, well, obviously brute force it's not going to work because it's only going to do 4 characters. So let's start back up again. Remember, it's still working on the brute force. It's already found the 2 passwords. And this is running in a VM, Windows with, I set this to 1.5 gigs of memory. Notice that it's loading the rainbow tables in RAM. And it's already finding some other passwords. Notice how quickly that's working. Some of these I know it's not going to find. And I can't tell you what those are right now because, wow, it actually found that one. Okay. And it's done. So it went through all those rainbow tables. Notice that it got all the passwords except 2. And these were taken, I think, from an African dictionary and from a Norwegian dictionary. And they're very long passwords. I think they're over 14 characters. Notice this one that comes from an Italian dictionary, it actually found with the rainbow table. It broke the last part with the brute force. And in the rest, I guess it found it in the rainbow table. So, Bobcat password in capital letters. Notice that this is the actual uppercase, lowercase name here. So that was found because it's over four characters with a rainbow table, Bobcat with a rainbow table, that with a combination of both rainbow table and brute force. Steelers, even down here, New York Yankees, it found. So the reason this worked very quickly is because all the pre-computation of, for example, computing a dictionary had already been done. So computing a hash is a complex and computationally intensive process. And by using rainbow tables, what you do is you take that computationally intensive process and extract that because you've already got those hashes in the rainbow tables. To do this efficiently, you're going to need a lot of RAM because you want your rainbow tables in RAM. And then everything else runs pretty smoothly and fairly quickly because all you're doing is making a comparison between the two files. Notice that the time elapsed was 1 minute and 10 seconds to run through all these passwords. Obviously, if you're doing a dictionary attack, it's going to take much longer because you're having to take each word from the dictionary and calculate a hash from it and then do the comparison. So off-crack is a very nice and efficient alternative to many other password auditing tools. However, the success with which you identify the passwords is really determined by the rainbow tables